So I'm honored to join this moment of prayer, and also after the words that we just heard, the words that were read to us, we understand that God is merciful and He's calling us to repent, and He's ready and fast to forgive us. And we are here in the beginning of Lent, and we are going to be giving the ash on our forehead, and it's going to remind us who we are, but also it's going to tell us that it's not only that we are clay, but also that the clay is a transforming clay that could turn into eternal life. We have to be aware of this gift, this magnificent gift that God has passed along to us by giving us a supernatural life. And we have to live according to the supernatural gift that has been entrusted to us, and that God so graciously and generously has given to us. And we are administrators of that gift. Today we are here acknowledging the gift, and God is asking us in this humble spirit of His to recognize what He's given us and to recognize the greatness of it, how it will lead us into eternal life, and how this is not just a gift, it is something that will last forever. So we have to really acknowledge that though we are so fragile and our life is so vulnerable, and we are so sensitive to not knowing the mystery of our lives, and we struggle every day with trials and toils and tribulations, and sometimes with the hardening of our hearts because of the scars of the past and the scars of sin. And we travel with this baggage, and we come here to rest and ask the Lord to heal us and to deliver us and to enlighten us and to inspire us to be better, to change, to have hope, and to have understanding. And all of that begins today in a very special way when we enter Lent and we receive the ashes, because God is coming to tell us, though you are made of clay, I blew in your clay, in this clay, life, and this life is real. And if you embrace the life that is in this clay, then you will be eternally living and dwelling in the glory that I have promised you. And I know these words are old, and this is an old sermon, but God wants to tell us time and time again about this old sermon, because we need to remember that. It's like parents, they always have to tell the children that they love them. It's not an old saying, it's just that it has to be renewed. We have to tell each other and reinforce each other that we love one another. Children say that to the parents, parents say that to the children, husband to the wife to the husband. We need to reinforce each other. And God comes along and He tells us time and time again, here He is in another land, and He's telling us again, I forgive you. I invite you to repent. Repent, confess your sins, recognize that you are a sinner, and come and kneel, be humble. Humble yourself as I am humble, and I will transform you. I will turn this clay you made of into a life that will last forever. And my promise is real. And that promise is alive today in this temple. This is God in the midst of us, and He came here to embrace us, to heal us, to hold us, to give us rest, to give us this comfort that we need within ourselves. We all have this incredible life that is unexplainable, unfathomable. And we are here holding this mystery, but the only one that has the answers is here, the Lord. And He is going to answer to us every question that we have. But we need to believe, like He asked St. Thomas, blessed are those that believe without seeing. That is the calling of us today. So we have to embrace the gift of Ash Wednesday as the entrance into the desert, and a desert where we are going to see the naked truth, that we are going to confront ourselves with a true reflection as to who we really are today. Because we could easily fool ourselves by being so busy living our temporary life. And we get to be so busy about everything that is earthly and temporary, that we completely forget about the sense of eternal life, and that will take us by surprise. That's why the Lord is warning us, lovingly so, that Lent is a preparation for eternal life, for the journey that awaits us at the end of this temporary life. And we know that that time can come anytime, only God knows. It could come up tonight, today. So therefore, this incredible invitation of the Church for us to go into the desert of conversion and to open up our hearts and to be brave enough to face ourselves and find out who we really are. If we are really people that are looking to embrace what God is asking us to embrace, to obey Him, to know Him better every time, to love Him, to learn how to love Him. And that is the reason He created us for. He created us in order to know Him, to obey Him, to love Him. And that is the calling of God. So we have to look at ourselves and find out, am I a better human being than I was a year ago, a month ago? Am I a pilgrim that is walking towards the house of the Father? Or am I just an earthly human being that is looking for temporary gain, and I'm just concerned about my temporary life, and I'm so miserable because things are not working out the way I expect them to work out, and I have all these fears and frustrations and anxieties because I have no hope and no faith. Who am I today? And the Lord is asking us to recollect. This is Lent, recollection, and to find out in our little privacy. That's why the word is saying, when you pray, go into your room and do it with the Father on your own. Don't let anybody know. There you go, in your little chamber of the soul, where you and God are together and talk to Him intimately and just tell Him who you are. It's not that He doesn't know, it's that it is the way to speak to God. You know, when we have children and we know what is going on in their lives, it is wonderful when they come along and share with you what is taking place in their lives, though you know it, because that means there is a communication, there is a love, there is a humbleness, there is something that calls a communion. And that's what God is asking us to do. When we come to confession, God knows our sins. He knows that. He also knows that He's going to forgive us. But He wants us to understand that we are free, and that we have this free will, that we can walk along with it as far as we want to. But He is always telling us, come along and just kneel and tell me everything that is wrong with you, and I will make you new. I will transform you. That is the sacrament of confession. It's an amazing healing. This Lent is about that, repentance. Father was talking about how watered down, how weak the sacrament of confession is among some people, some groups. I will say I travel around the world, and it's not only among English-speaking people. It is among humans everywhere, Catholics everywhere. Obviously, in Latin America, still we have a sensitivity still alive for the reverence and understanding of that particular sacrament of confession. And we still have confessions very healthy today, thanks God. But worldwide, the Catholic Church is suffering from a weakness. It's like the sacraments have been watered down by this materialism and by this consumism, by this fast living, a life that is so hyperactive, that we get so busy about our earthly life. Everything about God becomes just another activity, just something to add to the basket. It's something else we shop along with everything else. It's just one more activity. We do not have one life in God. We have one life with everything. And then from all of that, we make a little island for ourselves. So God is calling us to really wake up and to understand that the world has seduced us and has conquered us. And we have to understand that that is not the life that God gave us. God wants us to renew our hearts and to understand the power behind the sacraments, the power behind this church. This is a magnificent gift, the gift of the faith. And the liturgy teaches us all these seasons. The season of Lent is a precious gift, because if we really understand what Lent means, we understand that there is a big mystery behind it. The number 40 goes along with a lot of events. You see, the flood was 40 days, and then Elias and Moses were 40 days up in the mountain. The people of God were 40 years in the desert. Jesus was in the desert 40 days, and in those 40 days he was tempted, and he redeemed the 40 years of the people of God in the desert and taught us how to deal with Satan on those three temptations. Because one of the things we can do during this Lent, which will be so transcendental for our reflections and our meditation and our faith and the struggle to change, will be to meditate on the three temptations. If we read them, we will understand demonology, because Jesus taught us who the devil is and what the devil can do and what is he up to. On those three temptations, you can see everything about the devil. I don't think there is a better teaching of demonology than the three temptations of the desert. All you had to do is to ask the Holy Spirit to translate that particular event in the desert with Jesus into your little life. So therefore, you could see every temptation related to your personal life. And that way, you will know how much the devil is working in your life and how much have you bought in from him. And then it's good, because then you find out what is it that you have to deliver from your life. Because we sometimes do not notice that the devil has taken a lot of our territory and has come into our hearts and brought a lot of darkness, a lot of fear, a lot of depression, a lot of anxiety, lots of resentments, lots of hardening of the heart, darkness of the soul, and he has taken our love away, the love of God. And then we don't have compassion, we don't have patience or tolerance, we don't have anything that comes from the virtues of God, because the devil has taken it out. And then we, during this time of Lent, have the great opportunity to have an overabundance of graces, because the Lord pours amazing graces over his people during Lent, so that we can embrace repentance and come alone and renew ourselves and gain the peace that we have lost, gain the love we have lost, gain the compassion we have lost, gain the patience and tolerance we have lost, and that is the gift of Lent. So we should walk along to this desert and embrace the gift of Lent by understanding today that these ashes that we are going to receive are a great testimony of our faith, and how good that we come here at this time of the day to have the ashes on our forehead, and when we walk out, we can testify to our faith. Because we could evangelize just by walking through the streets with the ashes on our forehead and to show who we are and what we are about. It is a great way and a great opportunity to testify. Because I tell you, the day you go before the tribunal of Jesus, those ashes that you wore and you walk along with them in the streets, those ashes are going to be a testimony for your soul, in behalf of your soul, before the tribunal of the Lord, because you did testify for Jesus and you were not ashamed. You were showing your faith and you were showing the truth that was revealed to you and the responsibilities that were passed along to you. And then when you walk out like a soldier of God that is wearing the uniform and going out and showing the world that Jesus is alive in your life and that you're not ashamed. Amen.